The Xerox Iridesse production press combines the value of highly automated, agile digital production with exceptional image quality and jaw-dropping embellishment effects, making it easier to unleash new potential with print and achieve remarkably brilliant results. One of Iridesse's truly unique capabilities is printing real metallic iridescent hues, which lets you specify a full rainbow of eye-catching metallic colors on any job. The press makes a metallic hue by merging tints of gold or silver under tints of CMYK. You may want to use a metallic hue as a spot color in a graphic or logo. The challenge can be knowing exactly how to select the color so you and your client know what to expect when the job prints. Xerox has made that easier by creating a set of predefined metallic swatches. You can get a printed copy from your Iridesse print provider, along with an electronic swatches palette that can be loaded into Adobe InDesign. Loading the electronic swatches is simple. In InDesign, go to the Swatches palette. From the menu, select Load Swatches, then navigate to the electronic file from your print provider. Click Open. The metallic swatches will immediately load into your swatches palette. Now you can simply identify the color you like from the print, then select it from the swatch palette for use in your design. This makes specifying metallic hues as easy as specifying Pantone colors, and because it's digital, you can spec dozens and dozens of them in a single job. Another stunning use of metallic hues is in illustration. This polar bear is a great example. It uses straight silver, metallic hues, and clear in addition to CMYK. Doing work like this is less about specifying exact colors and more about forming an artistic impression. So we custom created our metallic hues versus using the predefined swatches palette. We started with CMYK artwork and dissected it to add the specialty enhancements. You can see the original CMYK here next to our final art as a comparison. Now let's look at our work process in Adobe Illustrator. Okay, it's time to start dissecting the polar bear art so we can understand what will be CMYK, a solid silver or tint of silver, an iridescent metallic color, and clear. Occasionally, a job lends itself to having duplicate specialty and CMYK layers to more easily manage the objects. In this example, we use a base silver underlay layer followed by a CMYK layer. This creates the silver sky, the iridescent watercolor, and the solid CMYK portions of the polar bear. The second silver layer is used for solids and tints of the silver on the polar bear. The second CMYK layer is used to create the iridescent metallic color on the polar bear. The clear layer adds the graphic embellishments. First, let's add our silver and clear swatches to our file. We'll take a look at the objects on each layer to see how they are being defined. We'll start with the first silver layer. Here we are using 75% silver as underlay to create the sky and base for the iridescent water. While this is subjective, a somewhat smoother metallic color can be achieved by using less than 100% silver as an underlay. Working with your print provider to review a couple of proof options can help determine the exact look you want. Now, let's continue with our first CMYK layer. Here, we selected the water gradient, selected Multiply under Transparency, and adjusted the opacity for the desired effect. In the second silver layer, we have varying tints of silver, ranging from 50 to 100%. On the second CMYK layer, we are multiplying the objects to create the iridescent metallic hues on the polar bear. To create the clear embellishments, simply go to the clear layer, draw or paste in the shapes you want, and fill them with the clear spot color. Again, you need to be sure to multiply so the clear prints correctly. It's a good practice to show all layers to make sure everything is registering properly before you hand off your file. Once printed, it's just stunning. When a file is ready to be saved as a PDF, there are specific settings that need to be checked. Under Adobe PDF Preset, select Press Quality. On the Compression tab, ensure all image types are set to Do Not Downsample, and under Output, there should be No Color Conversion, and the Profile Inclusion Policy should be set to Include All RGB and Tagged Sources. Lastly, under Advanced, make sure to note subset fonts when the percent of characters used is less than 100%. Then, click Save PDF. Be sure to review the Iridesse Design and File Preparation Guide for more ideas, tips, and detailed instructions on how to use the Xerox Iridesse Production Press to unleash more high-value wow per page for all your digital jobs. Now that's brilliant. Visit Xerox.com to learn more.